Hey everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and this video will be a short quick tip on edge control using the extrude tool. I will be using 3ds Max 2013 for this video, and this video assumes that you have an intermediate knowledge of modeling. Using the extrude tool for edge control can sometimes be quicker than using the swift loop tool. This is meant most for when you are creating a high poly mesh. I found myself using this workflow often when I come across a model that needs to be quickly shaped up into a high poly model. This workflow works best when you have a continuous edge that needs edge control. It doesn't work too well when the edges are not continuous, but you can get away with it in some cases. The way it works is by selecting the edges that you want supported, and then extrude them along the width. You want to keep the height at 0 because you don't want it to extrude like that. You want to move these support edges. I can show this real time by throwing the turbo smooth on here, and then going back to the editable poly, and then putting on the show end result. And then go to edge mode by pressing 2, and I have that edge selected already. And I'll just extrude that edge like I did before. And if I make this smaller and larger, you can see that the edge gets bigger and smaller. If I try this in the cube, I can only choose one set of the sides to be a continuous edge. So for this, I'll choose the top and the bottom. So I'll select all the edges and then deselect the middle ones. So if I extrude these, I'll get the looping that I want, but then I have these edges to deal with. And if I extrude these, then I will get this weird loop up here, which I don't really recommend, but you can get away with it. I can get away with it by using the turbo smooth and do a couple iterations and turn wireframe off, and you can see that it looks like a nice high poly model. For edges that loop like that, I would just use the swift loop tool instead to avoid any messy geometry like this. If what I just did confused you in any way, it was the swift loop tool. I have a video up using the swift loop tool on the 3dmotive YouTube page. I recommend watching it if you want to know how to use it. I won't get into that in this video because I want to explain another way to add control edges that works just as efficient. I have this cylindrical pillar that I'll add some control edges really quick. If I approach this using the swift loop tool, it would take some time and would give you uneven results. So if I did it like this, some of my edges can be uneven compared to the rest. And for something like this, I would want all my edges to be somewhat even on their edge hardness. So instead of going all the way up the model, doing every single edge like this, it'll take some time. If I approach this with the extrude technique, I could ring all the edges and then deselect the edges I don't need. So hit F3 to go wireframe and then deselect that edge, because I know I don't need it. And then now I have it all ringed, and then I need to loop these. So that way I can extrude the edges and give them some support loops. So I'll hit extrude and then turn the width down a little bit. So I want all my edges to have like the same width, like that. And I know that every edge will have the same width and it will have an even turbo smooth. If I throw a turbo smooth on, I'll have a nice high poly model to bake from. These railings have a continuous loop because I have the ends deleted right here. So you can see that if I ring all these and loop all of them, it will extrude no problem because there is no face here to intersect with it. So if I extrude it, you can see that it won't do any of that weird triangulation thing right there. And then I can just turbo smooth this and it's good to go. One of the main points I'm trying to get across is that you can choose which way you want to add the support loops. For something like this, it's easier to select the edges that you want and then loop them and then extrude them, because it's done that quickly. It takes longer with a swift loop tool because you have to add each loop individually and you have to rotate around your model to make sure that you're getting the right edge and stuff like that. So it just takes more time. It's easier to just select the edges and then loop and then extrude. And remember, sometimes it's not going to be this easy. You have to decide whether you're going to use the extrude technique or you're going to use the swift loop tool. That's it for this quick tip. My name is Cordell Felix. And thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.